السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. continue إن شاء الله تعالى with سورة الممتحنة and verse number four. verse number four from سورة الممتحنة. recite first إن شاء الله. so try to repeat إن شاء الله. correcting the recitation. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قد كانت لكم أسوة حسنة في إبراهيم والذين معه إذ قالوا لقومهم إنا براء منكم ومما تعبدون من دون الله كفرنا بكم وبدا بيننا وبينكم العداوة والبغضاء أبدا حتى تؤمنوا بالله وحده إلا قول إبراهيم لأبيه لأستغفرن لك وما أملك لك من الله من شيء ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير Okay, so قد كانت the دال with سكون قلقلة قد كانت لكم أسوة حسنة this is إخفاء أسوة the تنوين is normal حسنة في من مد إبراهيم والذين معه إذ قالوا لقومهم إنا براء then for the five counts منكم إخفاء ومما two counts ومما تعبدون من two counts إخفاء من دون الله كفرنا بكم وبدا بيننا وبينكم العداوة والبغضاء أبدا and the باء في البغضاء is light والباء and then the غين is heavy والبغضاء أبدا حتى تؤمنوا بالله وحده إلا قول إبراهيم لأبيه لأستغفرن نون شدة takes two counts لا أستغفرن لك وما مد for the five counts أملك لك من الله من شيء إخفاء ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير and the rise light transition of the ayah that has already been for you an excellent pattern in Ibrahim عليه السلام and those with him When they said to their people, indeed, we are disassociated from you and from whatever you worship other than Allah. We have denied you and there has appeared between us and you animosity and hatred forever until you believe in Allah alone. Except for the saying of Ibrahim to his father, I will surely ask forgiveness for you, but I have not power to do for you anything against Allah. Our Lord, upon you we have relied. And to you we have returned, and to you is the destination. This ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is giving the believers more evidences and ways for them to be firm upon the fact that they should never ever loyal themselves or give loyalty to their enemies, to those who are in enmity against the believers. They don't wish any good for them, as it's mentioned in the previous verses. They wish for you to be disbelievers. and they wish they would cause any harm to you, they are in state of enmity against you. So how can you be loyal to them? As what happened to Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a radiallahu anhu when he tried to give the disbelievers a favor, do to them a favor in the war with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And that's why these verses were revealed. So here in this ayah, قَدْ كَانَتْ لَكُمْ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ فِي إِبْرَهِيمَ وَالَّذِينَ مَعَ, that indeed you have أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. And al-uswa, as mentioned before, is the clear example or the proper way to follow. And we'll talk about that, you know, linguistically, inshallah ta'ala. قَدْ كَانَتْ لَكُمْ, that means indeed you have, there is for you, right, an example. And human beings, the way they function with regards to commands, and especially the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have the direct command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you need to understand it very well to be able to fulfill it in the most perfect way, because this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the need for the human beings to have an example to follow. And the example to follow is from another human being, that he practiced that command in the most perfect way. And people do that in their livelihood matters. Instructions only, sometimes it can be not clear because it's not put in practice. The same thing, for example, you've might learned how to make Hajj perfectly, and you learned the rulings of Hajj and the pillars and the wajib and everything and what expiates what and so on. But then if you've never been to Hajj before, with all of the knowledge that you have, you would need someone to still guide you, because you never practically done it before. So you would have a guide, someone that you would follow. And the Prophet والسلام, when he went to Hajj with the companions radiallahu anhum, he did not give him a lecture of how to make Hajj, but he said, خذوا عني مناسككم, take from me your manasik, learn from me. While the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is with them, they would follow the Prophet والسلام. And he said, صَلُّوا كَمَ رَأَيْتُمُونِي أُصَلِّي, pray in the same way that you saw me praying, and so on. So after the command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the believers not to have loyalty or associate themselves in a way that would harm them or harm the believers or doesn't undermine the superiority of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after saying all of this, then giving them the example from Ibrahim alayhi salam. So قَدْ كَانَتْ لَكُمْ, indeed, no doubt. لَكُمْ, here to you, referring to the believers. Uswatun hasana. Al uswa, again, example, the proper pattern, the proper way to follow. Hasana, good. That means you need to follow that. Fi Ibrahim wa alladhina ma'a, in Ibrahim and those who are with him from the believers. And Ibrahim alayhi salam, a great messenger of Allah, and you have been commanded to follow the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And ittabi' millata Ibrahim hanifa wa ma kana min al-mushrikeen. In what specifically? Idh qalu liqawmihim, when they said, if the verse 2 time, when they said to their people, inna bura'a'u minkum, bura'a', that means we distant ourselves, we disassociate ourselves, we disloyal ourselves from you and from what you worship besides Allah. So they disassociated themselves, declared that clearly, from the disbelievers and from what the disbelievers are worshiping besides Allah. So their disassociation here is from the disbelievers because of their disbelief. And they made it very clear even to them afterwards. Their enmity was made expressed in a clear way. كَفَرْنَا بِكُمْ, it means we disbelieve in you of what they're worshipping besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبَدَى بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمُ الْعَدَاوَةُ وَالْبَغْضَاءُ, that it becomes very clear and apparent between us and you. العداوة, the enmity, and البغضاء is the hatred. So the love in the heart is not there, because, and this is the love when it comes to matters of, because of their disbelief. And this is abadan, that means it's forever. You know, abadan, that means it's forever, as long as you stay in your state of disbelief. حتى تؤمنوا بالله وحده, till you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Once you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, that He's the only one worthy of worship, then this enmity and this hatred becomes love and loyalty and all kinds of things. إِلَّا قَوْلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ, except one thing that Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said to his father, and his father was a disbeliever. It was said to his name to be Azar, that he was a disbeliever, mushrik, and he opposed the truth. So the only exception here that Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said to his father, لَأَسْتَغْفِرَنَّ لَكَ, that I would seek forgiveness for you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا وَمَا أَمْلِكُ لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, and I do not own anything for you from Allah. Everything is by Allah. I can just ask for forgiveness for you, but at the end, everything is owned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا أملك لك من الله من شيء. But and this what it means here, except, right? That means Ibrahim alayhi salam was a clear and a good example for you in this matter, in this subject, except when he said to his father, I would ask for forgiveness for you. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala corrected Ibrahim alayhi salam afterwards, as it's mentioned clearly in the Quran, وَمَا كَانَ اسْتَغْفَارُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ لِأَبِيهِ إِلَّا عَمَّ وَعِدَةٍ وَعَدَهَا إِيَّا فَلَمَّا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ أَنَّهُ عَدُوُّ لِلَّهِ تَبَرَّأَ مِنْهُ إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ لَأَوَّاهٌ حَلِيمٌ. This was for Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he realized that he is the enemy of Allah, he disassociated himself from his father, right? So then the fact that he did this so that nobody would have an excuse, Ibrahim alayhi salam was corrected afterwards and he disassociated himself even from his father. وَمَا أَمْلِكُ لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. And then the ayat says, and this is what the Ibrahim alayhi salam and the believers, they said to show that how they are in need of Allah and they have no power, no might whatsoever. رَبَّنَا عَلَيْكَ تَوَكَّلْنَا. Our Lord, upon you we rely. And the significance of a tawakkul here is because if the believers disassociate themselves from the disbelievers, right, that means this is can bring the fear in their hearts that the disbelievers might hurt them. Who's they going to rely upon? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You rely upon him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he's the one that will protect you. رَبَّنَا عَلَيْكَ تَوَكَّلْنَا وَإِلَيْكَ أَنَبْنَا. And you are the one, oh, our Lord, that we return to. We return to with repentance, with obedience, with doing good deeds. وَإِلَيْكَ أَنَبْنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرِ. And to you, oh Allah, is al-masir, or the return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the next verse, which inshallah we'll continue that tomorrow inshallah with the next verses, but it's still continuing with the dua. Continuing with the dua of the believers and how it is, it's so important for the believers if they are upon al-Islam and al-Iman in the most perfect way. So that means that this might bring enmity against them, especially when they are firm upon their belief and they make it very clear. So therefore they need to do lots of dua and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely and rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help them and he would guide them subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the next, you know, verses continuing with that dua that would help them in such a state, in such a state of being in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with regards to this matter, with disassociating themselves from the disbelievers. So in Ibrahim alayhi salam, the best example and how he was so loyal to his Lord and the deen of Allah and to the believers. And in the Prophet ﷺ, he followed Ibrahim ﷺ in the most perfect way in this matter, and how that the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the, and the believers are the ones that they are commanded to loyal themselves to. Now this is something that the messengers of Allah, all of them, they were upon this. You know, and as also the meaning of this ayah is mentioned in Surah Al-Zukhruf, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ إِنَّنِي بَرَاءٌ مِّمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي فَإِنَّهُ سَيَهْدِينَ. When Ibrahim, he said to his father and his people that I disassociate myself from what you worship besides Allah, except the one that fatarani, except the one that created me, and he will guide me. And this is the meaning of La ilaha illallah, because La ilaha, that means disbelieving in anything that has been worshipped besides Allah, and declaring that clearly, and affirming that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. So this is how the ayat is. And because of that, you know, what they try to do to Ibrahim alayhi salam, they're trying to kill Ibrahim alayhi salam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him from his enemies as a result of his firmness upon the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we look at the words of the ayat, قَدْ كَانَتْ, indeed you have, لَكُمْ, for yourself, أُسْوَةٌ, and الْأُسْوَة is, you said, as an example, someone to follow. And Uswatun Hasana, that means that can be a bad uswa, a bad example, or a good example. So this is from the Alif Sin Waw. And this is from when it comes to follow, basically. قَدْ كَانَتْ لَكُمْ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, from Hasan, في إبراهيم, in Ibrahim عليه السلام, وَالَّذِينَ, and those who معه, those who are with him, meaning معه, with al-Iman, with faith. إِذْ قَالُوا, when they said, لِقَوْمِهِمْ, to their people, from قَافْ وَوْمِيمْ, إِنَّا بُرَآءَ, بُرَآءَ, from بَأْرَ أَلِفْ, and al-Bara'a is to disassociate, is to disloyal. And al-bur'a, as we said before, is to distance yourself or to be cured from a disease. So that disassociation, that means they're not with them, they're not like them. برآء منكم from yourself ومما and from what you worship. So it's both from the individual and what the individual worship. Not just what the individual worship besides Allah, but also the individual, because the worship of other than Allah is not in the air, right? It's done by human beings. So the human beings are the ones that are doing the evil. Once they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they're not evil anymore. من دون الله, from other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, كفرنا, we denied or disbelieved بكم. And you وبدأ from دال واو بدو is to be apparent, to be clear. بيننا وبينكم, between us and yourself, العداوة. العداوة from عين دال واو, enmity. والبغضاء and hatred which is in the heart. So physical and non-physical. أبدا forever. حتى تؤمنوا. Till you believe. From ألف ميم نون. حتى تؤمنوا بالله وحده. Alone. إلا except here the exception. قول إبراهيم لأبي. So for his father. لا أستغفرن لك. That means I will surely ask for forgiveness for you. فمغفرة. وما أملك لك من الله من شيء. And I do not own from ملك لك من الله. For you. From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من شيء. From anything whatsoever. And ربنا our Lord. عليك توكلنا. From واو كاف لام. التوكل وإليك and to you. عليك upon you. And to you. أنبنا return. From نون واو باء. And الإنابة is to return. And to stay in that state of return. وإليك المصير. And to you is the مصير. Or the end of things. And from صاد ياء راء. From صاد ياء راء. So as you see, the benefits here clearly from these verses is to be firm upon matters of al-Iman and the obligation of following the righteous ones and following the prophets of Allah and the forbiddance of making oneself loyal to the disbelievers or to the enemies of Allah, even if they are the closest to oneself. And that ends once they return to al-Iman wa al-Tawheed and to be firm upon the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بارك الله فيكم وكنتين إن شاء الله تعالى with more of these verses next time. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم, والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.